Hey there! Welcome to another episode of Dear Blocko, the show where I answer your questions about your world and my world. Alright, Cubot, X3000, search through all the comments and find me a good one. Let's see here, what do we got? Oh, whoops. forgot to turn on the safe search filter. Definitely can't answer that one on YouTube. Okay, perfect. Trembo asks, Dear Blocko, what if Earth and Saturn switched places? Well, to start with, if the Earth moved farther away from the Sun, all the water would freeze, making life pretty much impossible. Where Earth is now, the average temperature is 15 degrees Celsius, and the coldest it gets is minus 98 degrees Celsius. And that's only for a short period of time. While at Saturn's current location, the average temperature is negative 140 degrees Celsius. So that's a pretty big difference. But switching locations doesn't mean that Saturn would suddenly be able to support life. First of all, Saturn doesn't have a solid surface. It's just a big ball of gas. And second of all, if it moved closer to the Sun, it would lose its atmosphere, which is needed to keep the warmth in and the radiation out. The heat would excite the molecules and could make them reach escape velocity, where they could break free from the planet's gravity. This is how we lose hydrogen here on Earth. And since Saturn's atmosphere is primarily made up of hydrogen and helium, which are both lightweight molecules, it could leave the planet without an atmosphere. Second question up, let's see what we got. Ryan O asks, Dear Blocko, is it true that the day I die is already determined? Well, sort of. The upper limit is, at least. In general, cells can divide about 50 times before the telomeres, or junk DNA, on the end of the chromosomes is used up. This is called the Hayflick limit. Once it's gone, any further cell division could damage the chromosome. So the cell dies. Some scientists believe that if they could prevent telomeres from shortening, they could extend our life expectancy. But as for a lower limit, while there's definitely a genetic component, such as predisposition for certain diseases, it also has a lot to do with your lifestyle. Some environmental agents like pollution and radiation can damage your genes. But there are many other social factors like access to healthy foods and living in a safe and clean neighborhood that can influence one's health. These can cause epigenetic changes, where the genes aren't damaged but turned on or off, altering how they work. As you live your life day-to-day and make decisions that impact your health, your life expectancy can change, so make good choices. And now it's time for a question about me or my world. Nolan Q asks, Dear Blocko, where does Triangle Bob even live? He actually just moved out. We used to be roommates, but Sir Clea and I decided that we needed a little more privacy, and our insurance company said that Triangle Bob was too much of a liability. You know, with him burning the house down at least 3 times. But him and Grieg are now roommates. Let's see what they're up to, actually. Triangle Bob, Grieg, where are they? Aw, they're playing a VR game together. Not sure why all their furniture is made out of aluminum foil, but you know what? To each their own. Triangle Bob finally found a friend who makes as little sense as he does. So, do you have any questions about your world and my world? Let me know in the comment section below with the hashtag DearBlocko. Your question might be a future episode. Click subscribe and hit the bell so you're notified every time we upload a new video, and click like, because Triangle Bob has tied those to his self-esteem. Click here to watch the last Dear Blocko episode we did, or click here to watch this video. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.